Greetings and welcome to another episode of Sonic Odyssey, the music video channel dedicated to bringing you the last five decades or so of music in discussion format to broaden the horizons of the viewer as well as open doors on music that you might not have considered before. Today we're going to be looking at a pretty interesting album. But before we dive into that, please remember to like, share, and subscribe to the video channel so you can stay up to date on all things Sonic Odyssey. Also, please consider visiting our Patreon campaign page, the link for which is in the show description just below the video. And there you can contribute a few dollars every month to help keep Sonic Odyssey going. It's the only ad revenue that I make off of these videos. Because I include music in my videos, I don't get the pleasure of YouTube video ad campaigns, and therefore I don't get any ad revenue. I count on the generosity and complete faith in my viewers to keep the channel going and going strong. Today we're going to be looking at an album which is kind of controversial, I guess. It's considered probably one of the biggest flops from the band themselves ever in their recording history, and they've been recording since 1974. The band is Kiss, and the album we're going to look at is their 1981 record called Music from the Elder. So why don't we kick things off with a bit of Music from the Elder. We'll start off with a snippet of The Oath. Music from the Elder is Kiss's ninth studio album. It's the first album to feature Eric Carr on drums, as well as the last album to feature Ace Frehley on lead guitar. It's considered by many people to be their greatest flop, their greatest failure in their musical recording history. And it comes with good reason. It really was a daring step for Kiss to take at the time that they did it. They had, prior to the Elder, released Dynasty and Unmasked, which were kind of rock-pop albums, stepping away from their more hard rock roots of their earlier albums, and they were looking for something different to do, and they ended up making a progressive rock album in a conceptual story form. And the story of The Elder is that of a mystical group called The Elders, who are looking for a way to maintain balance between good and evil, darkness and light in the world. And whenever one of the powers of good or evil gets a greater balance, then they seek to enlist a hero to right the wrongs and restore normalcy and balance to the order of things. So the elder opened up with the oath, which is kind of a good start, a good beginning to the storytelling of this narrative. It has lyrically the elements that point to a hero coming to rise to this challenge. And I think, for the most part, the album succeeds in trying to convey a story about a young man who is rising, being sought by this order to restore, be their champion, restore order to the universe. And by the end of the album, they find that he is indeed a worthy champion to rise to the wishes of the elders and bring on the forces of good. It is a story album. It is a conceptual progressive rock album, and it has a lot of orchestration and choir throughout. It is really a daring step for a band that, you know, gave us the rock anthem, rock and roll all night, party every day. This is a big departure for them, and it shows probably most prominently in the song Just a Boy, which Paul Stanley sings almost entirely in falsetto. And it tells how he is just a young boy, too young to be doing these things that they're asking of him. And so he has these insecurities and these fears that he shows in that song. But as other songs progress, we realize that it is only he who has this power and this ability to be a transformative figure and bring about the balance that is sought. I want to play for you another snippet from a song called Under the Rose, which is halfway through the album. The boy is still considering his position and whether or not he wants to be this champion for light. And so the chorus goes, "Do you understand? Will you sacrifice? Do you take the oath? Will you live your life under the rose?" And there's a tasty little solo that I chose to play for this particular piece. So let's give that a listen right now. Under the Rose. Under the Rose is followed by probably the only really successful song that came off of the album, which was the Gene Simmons song, A World Without Heroes. And that song itself paints the story of what a world needs and what a world is like without heroes. It's then followed by probably the biggest throwaway track, the song that, although maybe in the greater context, had there ever actually been a movie made for this movie, the song might have made more sense, but the song Mr. Blackwell really just seems out of place and is a complete toss away. But other than that, we have the last few tracks with The Odyssey and Escape from the Island, and my personal favorite, and the main reason why I felt this was an album worth reviewing, the song I is probably one of the most self-affirming songs that I've ever heard Kiss do, let alone any band. It's a song that speaks about how the power of the self and believing in oneself can really lead to the ability to achieve greatness and rise to the challenges that are presented. And so I guess that's kind of what the album culminates with. It gives us the answer of the young boy. He is going to rise to the challenge. He has the power. He believes in himself. And he's going to take on this challenge. Music from The Elder sways a lot in its varying style of musical forms. It's not just a rock album. It's not. It has the ballad. It has some heaviness to it, a little bit of heaviness to it in the form of Escape from the Island and Dark Light, Dark Light being the only song Ace Frehley sings on the album. But for all of these things that make it a progressive rock album rather than just a hard rock album, it really still lacks enough cohesion and enough to bring it to a greater level. I mean, we're not talking Yes levels of progressive rock here. We're talking Kiss doing progressive rock. And so with that in mind, I probably have to give this album about a 3 stars out of 5, 2.5, 3 stars out of 5. It makes good efforts, and it has really a couple of really great songs on it, but for the most part it languishes in its inability to bring the listener more fully into the story, as well as making the story something more important to be heard. For those reasons, I give it the score that I give it. And I thank you very much for watching. The surgery that I'm going to undergo has been delayed a week, so I might be able to get out another video before I go under the blade for my shoulder replacement surgery. But other than that, nothing much to report. I had a great trip to America, and I missed doing my videos, and I'm glad to be back. So thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the video, and please remember to like, share, and subscribe, and consider visiting the Patreon page. Other than that, have a great day, and until next time, bye.